Why you bought cactus?
I told him to take that arm down.
What happened?
The arm was out to his door, and he kept caution taping. He kept going around it, and he caught it in the dick.
Oh, fuck. Hey, did you get dicked by a cactus?
No.
What happened?
I'm good, Brandon.
No, you're not.
Let me go.
Oh, that sucks.
Do you have duct tape?
Yeah, I'll dig up, but. I'll get duct tape if you admit that you got cactus in the dick.
Don't with me right now, Kevin.
We're here on the Canadian border, pretty close, so they've got these, emergency stations, kind of like they have in like parking garages. You hit the button if like some creeper's stalking you. I guess this is Canadian riding of some sort. I haven't seen one before. Looks like just a radio antenna. There's a light on the top, so when you hit the button, I guess obviously it probably flashes. You cannot walk to safety from this point. You're in danger of dying. You do not summon help. And then it's written in Canadian below. If you need help, press red button. U.S. Border Patrol will arrive in 1 hour. Don't leave this location. And then some more Canadian at the bottom there. So, you know, what's kind of weird is, don't they look a bit like an actual alien, like a space alien, a little bit? I don't know, just observation. They look funny, yeah. I'm not sure why they're black, but, okay. Head frame and the hoist. It's actually a slight decline. To get my 6 foot level out of my backpack, and we'll see what the angle is. There's the bell signals. So 300. Wow. So it's all steel. Interesting. Pretty neat, and that's almost like a fiberglass-ish pipe. It's wrapped. Safety first. This is cool. Two of them, looks like 300 level face fan, and then fan. Imagine that's a heater. 12240 breaker panel. That's probably like a float switch, maybe. I'm guessing. We got some 18 volt DeWalt batteries. That's cool. Motorola. Oh, so this must be like a power source and like phone system. Probably way overkill for this mine, but you know, you gotta take what you can get. That's pretty crazy. Help and coax, it looks like. Huh. Okay, so it's not phone, it's radio. That's a big coax cable. Oh wow. Do you guys see the tags? Jesse, Dean, Kevin, and Matt. F**k Matt. Guy's an asshole. Jack. That's a blank one. And then... Man, he has his own sweet one.
Oh, there's like a... Oh, there's a... Do you guys see the big nest up there? Oh, do you guys notice the railing is made out of drill steel? That's cool.
We just got in this very cool miner's dry room. Kind of gonna go slow just because there's so much stuff. Safety first. Get your rescue stretcher. Ooh, there's some good boots here, rubber boots. Headphones. Ooh, old belt. Those are basically illegal now. That's a full body harness. That's fine. Got the chargers here. Job safety analysis. Again, safety first. These guys are awesome.
There's a mind map right there. What was that slam? Did you hear that?
No, I didn't.
Okay, that's what it was. It sounded like a... Sorry.
It sounded like a car door outside. It was in the fridge.
Got the shitter. Some toilet paper. More stuff. Oh wow, those are this is a like a boot dryer. Put your boots upside down in that. Shower room. No separators. Jason, you got a toothbrush.
New or used?
Used.
Thanks,
though. They're very hygienic here. Got some Head and Shoulders.
Left their towels and everything.
Come in front. 7 a.m. Safety meeting. These guys are awesome. When was this last checked? Ooh. Holy
shit. What do you got?
7 of 20? 7. It's monthly. So, but that's 19. 2019.
Well, that's 2020.
Yeah, but I mean, that's recent.
That's 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Well, no, you didn't hear me say the calendar up there. It's July of 2020.
Holy shit.
They did stuff. They rehabbed and did a bunch of work and moved a bunch of equipment since 2017.
Mm-hmm.
Josh?
So we have a 300 a pocket. I don't know what the pocket is. Usually it says a sump, but pocket, 200, 100, a 50 pocket, a collar.
Last time they worked the hoist was 7/14/2020.
7/14/2020. Wow.
But they've been here in 2021.
Test certificate.
Are these loads they took out, you think?
So this is a test certificate for the cable.
I'm guessing. Oh, 300W, so we have 300 level.
Mm-hmm. More mine signals. Bucket of grease. Other electric hoist. This is behind the hoist house. That's kind of neat. It's like a generator accessory. Yep, current generator. 125 volts, 5 kilowatts. That's interesting, because you've got this big generator right here. Where's the nameplate? Here's a nameplate. A Crocker Wheeler, 100 kVA generator. Okay, so this is the 480 volt generator. And that little one behind it is the 120, 240 generator. That's pretty interesting. I've never seen a setup like this where it one generator through the belts and the armature feeds the other one. 8-cylinder diesel. There's Maya coming down the wash. It's kind of messy. It's about a 2 foot something drop right there. We've been playing this real slow and steady. we're at the entrance here. Got the key from the owner. So we are gonna head on in. We have not been in here yet. Ultra calm. Not too sure what that is. Temperature sender, maybe? I'll have to look up the part number. Safety first. I love it. That was actually kind of freaky there for a second to turn the light on behind me. Saw my own shadow. Yeah, this is probably the man right here. Metal. Stations. Nice. This is fairly modern. So there's some, call it SO cord. Holy cow, tons of SO cord. So it's just a flexible conductor, right? There's three conductors and then four, five, six smaller ones. So probably three phases in your ground, parallel grounds, I guess. Although, I guess that's a 1-aught. You're not allowed to parallel anything smaller than 1-aught in the National Electric Code. So you can't parallel number 10s or number 12s. So tons of SO cord here, tons of money, tons of weight. There's the entrance. He's making pretty good time, but he's going downhill. Big air and water pipes. This is a big operation. And in your coax, I think, I'm guessing it's a radio repeater system somehow. It's interesting that they zigzag, but I bet they did that in case things move. Or maybe even stretch, somebody snags it, it won't rip the cord apart, it might just... Yep, that's exactly right. See, they're only attached with bungee cords. So if something was to get caught, it wouldn't break the cable, it would just kind of let the slack loops out, so pretty smart. Bunch of rock bolts. This is hard stuff here. But I'm surprised they put the rock bolts in. This is very big. I mean, it's six, at least 13 feet wide, 15 feet tall at least. Man, I really like the idea of that zigzag, and that's pretty smart. Obviously, you need to use a lot more cable, but if something breaks, it, you know, snags, it won't break the whole thing, and you got slack. Secondary escape way. So I wonder if that may be where our friends are coming down, but I don't know. Because it says secondary. So there's got to be a primary. So it splits off here. Oh man, look at this SO cord. I'm just getting all giddy. Holy cow. Steel reels because it's so heavy. Look at all that. Holy cow. Look at all this SO cord.
So check this out.
Okay.
What do you think that is? 4-0?
Yeah, that's probably 4-aught. I'm guessing maybe these are 1 because the largest conductor, the smallest conductor you're allowed to parallel is 1-aught. So I'm assuming it's 1-aught.
So price per foot.
So I'm gonna post it in the comments, but my guess off the top of my head is 15 to 20 bucks a foot.
Oh boy.
It's just the most dirt.
We're rich. You know. We hit copper.
Yeah. The only stuff stronger than this is the armored, so it has a metal corrugated spider sheath around it, but it's not flexible. You couldn't wrap it like this, so it's a lot of weight too. 10 pounds a foot. So we just met up with them. So you guys came down, I guess it's called the secondary escape way. Primary, that's where you're coming
primary.
From?
We came from the primary.
So you came from the left this way?
Yep.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay. Got it. Okay, so we didn't find that yet. So this is an example of some bad ground. You see they have the rock bolts in, but stuff has fallen anyway, and that's why the rock bolts aren't all the way inside. So the rock above the plates there has fallen. Same with that whole wall right there. So about 3 foot of that wall's come out. So they just said, screw this area. Just huge. Big ventilation pipe heading down further. Open hole. That's what I like to hear. Man, that's big diameter. 4 foot diameter pipe, flex pipe for ventilation. Keeps going down. So I don't have any idea where this pops out. Some harnesses. So they have about 5 kV down here. So this comes from the surface, 5 kV. Ooh, nice. Is this a raise bore? No, not quite, but.
Is that water right there?
Yes, water.
You got a rock?
Yes, I'll get one. This is like a really good rock right here. We'll give her a gander. Now I gotta make sure I throw my rock and not the phone. Water.
Yep. Flooded.
Yep. And then it goes up as
so
well.
So what was this? So you think this is where they were pumping the water?
Very well could have been.
What kind of current, what did you say they had down there? What kind of power?
4160. So they've got some big pumps that were here.
4160 big pumps.
Oh wow, look at that.
They were pumping air down there too.
Shine your flood up here. Wow.
Yeah.
That goes.
Big.
Yeah. But this is a stick for pulling out somebody that may be caught on like an electrical line, or getting electrocuted. It's a fiberglass pole, insulated, so you can basically grab them and pull them off without you grabbing them and then becoming part of the circuit and getting killed yourself. So it's pretty interesting. Get to certify these once a year. This was, there we go, August of 2012. Explosives.
Whoa, fuck. Yeah, it's empty. There's a log, though.
Check that out. Ooh, here's the manufacturer. 8,600 pounds, this thing. I don't know why it's steel. I mean, it's not like it's going to not blow up. So 13.
That was the date I saw somewhere else.
Powder mag, yeah, 2 sticks, 2.5, deck core boosters. Very cool.
Interesting that it's lined with wood on the inside. What do you think that's about?
I guarantee you that's moisture control. Man, they were here for a while.
Yeah, well, I would imagine so. Look at the pins here, like I say, on the back side of the door.
I guess to keep the door from maybe blowing out, but if anything went off in here, this thing would explode.
Well, I don't know about that. Oh, yeah. There's your construction. Look at how many layers. Plate, steel, hardwood, plywood. Standoff strips, plywood, total hardwood, nailers, standoff strips. Jesus, look at how many freaking layers.
Yeah, that's insane. This is the bottom of that manway that we came upon. This is where the guys came down and met us at the portal. And man, it's quite the hike up here. So we decided, hey, we can overland it, it's hot as heck, or just come back in here and take the manway up. It's inside, it's dark, it's cool, wind's blowing, and not exposed. So we've actually come up probably halfway to the vehicles already. This ladder's only 75 feet or so. The rest is literally like a corkscrew down this thing. So we'll see you at the top. This is a pretty cool location. We left that original location, came up, I don't know, quarter mile maybe. And this is obviously connected to it as well. I wanted to check out this big ass fan. Not to be mistaken for the actual company. Big ass fan. Feg. They make gearboxes. Different hydraulic stuff. Feg. I'm really trying to find a nameplate on this big bastard. This is Snake City here, back here. Big at it. Same with the other. Oh, that's big. That's probably 750. Compact. Fine strand.
Nice. Is that the 4160 cable?
No, that's 480 again.
So what does that cost per foot?
That stuff there? Yeah. This is probably 750 copper. I don't know. Close to $50 a foot.
Yeah.
I mean, look at my hand. Morning, YouTubers. New day, brand new line. This one's gonna be awesome. For the past blood days, our record. Let's beat that record.
I wouldn't want to share that because it gives a location.
I'm fuzzing it out right now.
Are you?
Yeah, but it does say U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, so this will be an interesting one. Let's check this baby out. Here's the boys coming up. I'm switching to wide angle mode so we can check out these buildings. I do have a mask on just because the guy said it was pretty bad in here last time. So we're naming this the Ordnance Mine because it appears that this mine was previously a mine, mining it for minerals, and then DOD, or Army Corps of Engineers, took over it and used it to test, we believe, test different explosive components and things like that. So there's a lot of crazy stuff you'll see that's explosive related. I don't know what reusable fast pack is, but look at the how they pack this, whatever was in here, right, with foam and everything. So obviously, pretty sensitive stuff they were handling. We'll head over to the next one. So this is the office the Army Corps engineers used. Wow, so these are for measuring like seismic activity, I think. Oh, look at that. Induction spherically focused log. Chance Oil Company. This is an oil company thing, though. Wow. Parts catalog. Tons of intelligence in here. This pile of just different steel, we believe, were set up next to or in the vicinity of some of these explosive devices that they were setting off and testing. Holy crap, so some of them are thin. Real thin pieces, but some are thick as hell. Holy crap. Like, look at the thickness of this right here. The steel plate, look at the spalling and everything. Get my shadow out of it. Man, oh man, imagine the explosives that cause these. What's weird is a lot of it is like heat and spalling. These are 2.5 inches thick. Other ones are just holes. I guess those are probably torched holes. But imagine the explosives and the amount of that had to go off to create all of this. This is crazy. I'm amazed at how thick some of these pieces are. Man, oh man. Yeah, they did some crazy testing in here, for sure. Some crates. Kind of going slow, just because of potential rattlesnakes. We've already come into a couple. So, steel cylinder loaded with Ampass 4. I don't know what that is, but we'll Google it. Ooh, what's this? It's not debt cord. It's maybe trying to find the end of one. That's a lot of it. I bet you it's conductor for the sensors, maybe? Focus. Don't really know. Focus. Anyway, yeah, it is like a 4 or 5 conductor, almost like a primitive Cat 6. So yeah, this was all for the different sensors that they had set up inside to measure, you know, whatever, pressure waves and all that stuff. Here's something we found. Look up what this is. Tri-tunnel charge, 215 pounds. Explosives. Charges bursting, plastic bonded. Huh. DOD, USA, wow. Taking a Frank and notice all these wires buried. You can kind of see them coming through. Right here, up there. Look at all of them coming out. Almost like this is where they had all the equipment. So this is the monitoring equipment, maybe? Holy shoot. Oh man, look at that. We got some there. There were tons of sensors. You know what? I bet they ran sensors all over this hillside. Registered impact and impacts and things. I see it going over the tree branch. There's gotta be sensors all over. There's another one going up the tree branch. Holy cow. Insane the amount of data they collected. So I guess right here in this flat area was, you know, conexes or something, but wow. This is definitely a very cool one. Okay, let's go. We brought quite a bit of batteries with us in this one because it's huge. So this has got to be mountain lion. We need to get the right angle on it. Like put your light to the side so you can get the, there we go.
Big wow. Kitty,
yeah,
small kitty.
Put your palm next to it to get a size. Wow. Holy shoot. Air hose, water, power right there. Big T condolet. So it's if they concreted the floor and the edges. I think they mounted sensors to this or something. So this is where we think they were doing the blasting.
Yeah, right there. Josh is down here. Yeah. Yeah, I think there was something back there. That's what it had.
Cord cap plugs.
They detonated one back here.
It's all concrete.
Sensors will mount on this. They're all out.
It sounds like this is the room where there's evidence of the explosions. Everything's kind of shotcreted and concreted. Did you guys figure out what these were?
That's the sensors. Those are the sensor mounts.
Oh, okay.
So they detonated down the hall in front of you.
Oh, here's like it's like a pitot tube almost.
Yep, and they would mount the external sensors, and the gauges would go in here, so the wave would hit, go through, and the wires went down into the wave guide or the channel. See, they buried the.
Oh, look at that.
That's
yeah.
Where the conduit is for the wires to go outside.
Wow. Yep.
And they detonate down there, and they.
Wow.
If you get farther down on the walls, you'll see the mounts where they ripped the glass doors off.
Huh. Problems?
Trying to reset it.
Sensors were mounted on these. So what Jason pointed out here on the left, this is the duct for all of the cables. All the sensor cables, and they concreted it in so they wouldn't get damaged. This is like something steel right there. Wow. There was something big here. They torched off. All these are torched off like it was maybe a blast door. I think somebody may mention that. Must have been a thick blast door. And more right here. Oh, I have multiple blast doors. So I think it's rough from the fragments.
But then look at this, this is totally flat right here.
Yeah.
Is that concrete?
Yeah. Because you can see where they put the plywood. Here's the edge of the plywood, the pieces.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is where they would put the materials to test them.
This is definitely different.
Never seen anything like this before. Crazy. Explosives testing mine. That's why we here. See, there's more of the steel. We'll nickname it something like demolition mine or something like that. But pretty unique setup. There you go, you can see the pillars stand out. All these pillars are holding this place up.
Yep. Rip the old seam.
Bless you. We'll get some context when he starts walking down this and paints it. Yeah, they're walking back here. Just check it out. It may or may not go through.
Yeah, I see it.
Could be a. It's probably an ore chute at the bottom. There's some good sized stopes, not the biggest, but you know, admirable. A lot of humidity in here, in this section. All right, heading underneath the ore bin. I think the guys have been underneath here for a while already. Yep, some more driftage. We're still headed the way it said out, but the way the track's configured, out would be opposite to what we're walking. So, see, this goes was going to go straight, and it's faced. Two faces here.
Not Stevie Wonder, because he's the guy with cornrows. Isn't he?
I don't think so.
No, Stevie Wonder never had cornrows. Stevie Wonder. He was the one.
We have some pretty serious conversations and debates down here.
No.
Totally wet.
I know who you're talking
just
about.
Just nasty,
I'm
watch.
I don't think that was Stevie Wonder. He was an old black guy, blind.
Because Stevie Wonder was
with piano.
He was in that
just
movie played by
Jason. Gone, man. Just like Sarah Bordo.
No.
The 400 level.
So that was the, I can see.
Listen to these guys.
I thought you're right. I thought that's Stevie Wonder.
Arguing about Wonder. Serious topics.
I swear it's Stevie Wonder.
Google it right now.
Just mazes of, well, this is cool. You don't see this too often. I mean, this is in bad shape, but it's a track changer.
Is it Lionel Richie, Christina Richie's father?
Let's see if it works.
He had the cornrows. Yes. So the other one was the one with the buzz cut, old, kind of hunchback.
Oh, it's rusted shut.
That's Stevie Wonder.
Yep, rusted shut.
Yeah, because he never would have had a daughter that acted like Christina Richie.
Where's
Boxy
going?
I think he's in here. To the left is out. See, again, it's just railed a dead end. Not really sure what this was for. Holding it up. Yeah, I guess just holding up the stuff that was falling here. Might want to come this way. It looks promising. I say it looks promising because it splits off. Oh, yeah, look at this. This is virgin territory for us now. Hell yeah. Oh, yeah, here we go. Decline, bitches. Let's get their reaction here.
Nice. Oh, a three-way. Ooh. Oh, three-way. We might have been here. We've been here before?
It's a decline behind me. Keep coming, I was gonna.
Did we not come up another decline? Remember we went down then up? I think we might have been here.
Yeah, we saw this horse.
Ah, well, you ruined everything.
We came from the other side, I thought. Came up.
Well, you ruined my video. I said it was virgin.
Oh, sorry. You can edit that out.
It's yeah. So it splits off into two and then back into one, which is interesting. Work car here, bad shape. Oh, okay.
Yep, the siding was the full ones. They just stack them up. And then they
you want to say that again?
What they do, they pull the filled ore cars up this slight incline, and they put a train together, and then they load it out.
Okay, so they pre-stage them until they have a full one.
Yeah, full train. Okay. Because you can only buy a car with a train. And then you could stash your empties on the side.
I'm not so sure. Should we even go down? I don't know if it's
Are you sure you explored the whole thing?
Excuse me. Sweet Christmas,
Rizal.
We've just been walking forever and getting a little wet, so we are switching to rubber. It gets dry for a minute. There's a little ore bypass station here where it goes double for a moment and then back to single. Maybe they pre-staged some cars here. And it's drying up. They did pull track and pull the support beam, so that's usually not a good sign. It's really pretty. Gross, but anyway, that water's just gushing out of there. So they actually had this pipe hooked up to it. So now we kind of learned a little bit about what's going on with these poly pipes. Earlier in the video where we hit the face of that water squirting out, your guys' guess, how far do we walk from where we were wet to here, you think? Mile? Mm. Not quite. Up, down, around, it goes into this tank. We open the valve, and then we'll open this one too. It's crystal clear water. So all that water was coming into this tank. Yeah, so these are core sample holders. Maybe like, I don't know, 3/4 inch? And then these blocks, they'd put a core in here, and if it went like 4 feet and it broke, they'd stick that in there and write, you know, 4 feet, and then the next section, and then the next section, so you'd have basically a full, basically one long deal. 21 times 4, I guess, 84 feet for a core sample, I guess. Shit, what the hell? Boxy, is that you? What is that? It's like a tarp? Boxy. What the hell? You messing with me? Very funny. Like an air dam? Boxy. What the fuck? That was straight up moving. Yeah, so that where that air dam was back there didn't go anywhere. So we're just gonna keep on keeping on. This place is cool. So it goes up, I don't know, 10 feet again. Stope, it goes across, and we have more track here in this big stope. It's like a, I guess this is the back side of where we came in from. We didn't see this. And it goes back down. So cool. Yep. We couldn't see the track because it was buried. So this is just one long stope. 92170. Zoo and nuclear bomb there. West Hall. I don't know what's up with zoo. Just shit.
Shit a night.
Shit a night. Oh, that's comforting. Some radiation nuclear signs there. Ooh. Ooh, nice.
Go around, look around the corner.
The controller's intact. Speed controller. Where are the grids? There they are. If you got a speed controller, you got grids, you got resistors. And it's chain drive. Pretty big in here. So I wonder if there was, yeah, so the electrical motor's gone. It went right here, I imagine. Yep, and there's the leads for the motor.
It looks like, because we were walking, I could see them up that way, so it looks like that goes up there.
Oh, this is neat. It kind of declines down with the rails. This is cool. Heading down. I feel like I'm holding the phone about level here. Sorry for the dust. We're heading on down. Huge. Huge. We'll pick it back up. Oh, look at that context of how big it is. Another pillar. holding this all up for us. Just keeps going down. Yep, a little slippery. Another pillar. 40 volts. Oh, okay, submersible pump has a contactor.
NEC code.
Yeah.
NEC code.
So, are we following the direction of the sump?
No, it's right here.
Oh, okay. Pump controller. Contactor, I don't know. Probably 480 to 120 transformer. Yep.
480 to 120.
Water. Was it water?
Didn't sound like it.
Oh.
It's ready. And no.
Holy shit. Quite ways.
Yeah.
It's like mold growing on that wood box. There is a little intermediate level. Oh, we need to find that. Huh, this kind of ends. Just some stoppage, I'll walk up it. So we're walking up this area. Found a box of dynamite. The good news is it's not sweating.
No.
Let's get a little closer here. Thought it wasn't sweating, so the nitroglycerin will leak out of the material inside. The material inside is usually like a like sawdust, almost, to keep it stable.
To keep it stable, but dynamite's pretty stable as is.
Yeah, but when the nitroglycerin leaks out, it's not. Okay. And look, it is literally right there. You can see it reflecting.
Okay.
So this is pretty unstable.
That's the dynamite.
Yeah.
Yep. So this is below where we were at the lowest point where Boxy was just photographing. I don't know.
That is so crazy that they would only have a manway or an ore chute connecting those two.
Ready?
Yeah.
Sure there isn't now.
Wow. I noticed this again. From where we last took the video, dropping the rocks down that ore chute, it was a big loop. We looped right back to where we kind of started. So there's another mine below that we were trying to access, but we believe it's only accessible through that ore chute. And clearly it's a mess. So we believe we've covered this whole thing now. We're heading back to the start. All right, so where you saw the video of us dropping the rocks down that ore chute, it went down way more than 200 feet. We're just thinking that chute has to go to a portal somewhere. Somewhere that ore is being dumped and picked up and pulled out. And we did some research and we believe we found it. The road's pretty bad, so we're leaving a couple of the big vehicles back. We're hitching a ride up to the top. We'll check it out. at the top. I am very glad for the ride. Very overgrown. Oh wow, water's dumping out of this thing. That is cool. It also makes sense because we're much lower than that other mine, and there was water in that other mine. Oh, this is really cool. So maybe, yep. Oh, that's interesting that it actually stopped. Usually they continue it as they grow the waste pile, but okay. Maybe one was waste, and see this one curves around. This is probably the ore, good stuff. Man, it's not as often that you see metal ore bins like this. Usually always wood. This is awesome. Attempt to balance. Well, moderately hungover. Just kidding. Here's some wood. This is cool. Wow. Do not enter the deadly gas.
Gases exist.
In my ass.
Blowing in does not make much sense. Okay, I know it
doesn't. Yes, this is slight pucker factor. We're on top of where the tunnel is, really, in the collapsed area. So, this isn't super. And everything seems pretty wet, damp, and soft. So, that's the exit there, some water. We'll keep on going, but not pretty. So we're glad we were able to kind of figure out what was going on in that mine, because we weren't seeing where they were taking it all out and where that ore chute went. This is definitely where it went. Just kind of fun to try to connect the dots, and it's great if you can actually do it. Don't know if we'll make it to the ore chute, but we'll see. They're coming. It gets deep and kind of shallow, and deep and kind of shallow, but straight line. All right, looks like we got a...
Is it any worse than what was at the entrance?
Obstacle.
Yeah, this whole fucking
group
blowing out.
Ah, shit, yeah.
You can look
They knew this was bad area already, that's why they crit the hell out of it.
All the bases are rotten
out. Oh yeah, these are providing like little to no support.
Yeah.
Holy...
Oops.
Ooh. Yeah, this is bad. Very bad.
Well, they probably had airbags.
Did you hear that? Oh my gosh, it's swinging. Is something there? Is there a ghost? Am I a douche? Well, you know how we roll. We don't scare easy, so we just went through that. And it continues, and those guys, oh, there's another one. And I think those guys just kept going. This is a long one. That's what she said. Yeah, this is like...
Although I might argue that the one behind
Boeing.
Us, if it went, it's just the loose shit on top.
Right.
We might have a passenger.
Jeez,
on top.
This is like buckling. Sure. Oh, this would be bad, yeah. All right, well, just got through this one. And this is just total dog poop. Total dog water. I think I'm probably about stewed. Pucker limit. Good news is it does clear up. Bad news is we may die any moment. Hopefully it'll be quick and you guys recover the phone, at least post a video, make some money on it. I actually really don't make much of anything on these. Enough to buy me about 1 to 2 cups of gasoline at today's market price. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Biden. Okay. I mean, Vladimir. I forgot, it's Vladimir's fault. I think we're finally at something, at least the first sign of anything different than a long-ass tunnel. Sorry, it's not a tunnel. It's an adit, but still nasty water. All right, cool. We got a split. Just walked back from there. We're kind of thinking that this is the chute because we haven't found any other chute. We know this is where they were taking it out. So it's got to be the bottom of where we were throwing those rocks yesterday on the top side. I don't know the total length. I don't know. It's definitely more than 200 feet. I'm guessing between 400 and 600 feet for that overshoot. We have one more way to check out. So we just kind of dug this out a little bit here. It was dammed up. I'm already kind of getting kind of wet here, but I'm hoping I can buy ourselves another inch or two of water, which might make the difference. It's flowing now. They're way up there. Being electrical guy, this is kind of interesting. This cable's been following us down here. Probably number 10. 1, 2, 3, 5. Five conductors, probably number 10. But it's unjacketed. Like, they've already twisted it all together. It's literally one extra process to jacket this and have it be much more protected. I don't know why they didn't just spend the extra couple cents a foot, if that, to jacket it. So I'm curious to see where it goes. And then on the way back, we'll see where it came from. As soon as I stopped the video, I got here, I spliced it in with some actual jacketed. This is more of an SO cord. This is like a fine strand copper. This is not fine strand copper. It's very stout. Like a TW installation or something like that. And this is the SOOW. It's very flexible and very durable, which is much more appropriate. They must have run out of budget. Had to go with the cheap stuff the rest of the way. Oh, and it goes up.
Remember the sump pump hole?
Yeah, this is the sump pump pole.
Yep. Side, I just like a good picture of it if someone wants it.
Yep, this is exactly it. That's right. So,
it's a bigger
then the sump pump must be way the hell back there.
It was underneath the water at the split.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Man, that's quite the voltage drop. We are complete with this mine. It's awesome because we actually got to the objectives. And it wasn't collapsed. Well, it was collapsed, but we overcame. Over and out. We made it out. Boxy's the last one in there. Awesome that we were able to connect all the dots. I did make one tactical error, and that was breaching that little dam there on the way back. That added additional flow to the main haul tunnel, which is obviously being restricted here. You can see it leaking through, but and it raised it up enough to go completely over my boots. I've got water in all of them. I'm completely soaked, but oh well, we made it.